Kate, what are your thoughts on the fight?
I have a lot to work on, but I was nervous, so it's a work in progress.
A win is a win, right? Champion.
Yeah, you support that. Are you okay today? You confident?
Later, yeah. No, later. Before fight.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Kate, what's your thoughts going into this second fight?
Right now I'm just trying to stay calm, be in the moment, just be present, so that when the time comes I can focus on the task at hand. That sounds so generic, but it's true.
Well, any game plan change from your last fight to this fight that you're going to try to adapt?
Well, this fight's going to be 5 rounds, so I think I'll try and take it slow the first round and feel it out, and go from there. Just listen to my corner. I'm not sure what to expect, so.
Thank you. Hey, Kate. What were your thoughts and game plan going to the fight, and how do you think it changed once the fight actually started?
Going into the fight, I didn't really have a game plan because I didn't know anything about my opponent, so I wasn't sure what to expect. I was kind of thinking that she might have an aggressive forward style, and kind of interested to see what would happen, because that's kind of how I feel my style is. And it turned out to be that way, and I wasn't expecting a 5-round fight. I thought it was going to be 3, so when I got there, I was like, oh my god, okay. Time to put it together.
did your mindset shift, and like what changed when you found out it was a 5-round fight as opposed to a 3-round fight? Did you go into the fight with any different type of mentality?
I thought maybe I should take the first round slow and try to fill it out more like a traditional Thai style of fighting. But she didn't really allow that, so I just had to maintain, I guess, stay focused.
When you found out she was a southpaw, how did that change your fighting style, since you didn't know that she was, you didn't even know who the opponent was, but then you found out she's a southpaw, what kind of changed?
I happen to like sparring with southpaws because I feel more comfortable moving to the left. So once you told me that she was a southpaw, it didn't occur to me in the first round, I was like, oh, okay, just move to the left. And I like to fire my right hand. The body was pretty open, so one thing I did like about the fight, obviously I'm very critical about my performance, but I liked that I listened and followed your instructions, so it was good.
In regards to like looking back at the fight and seeing the fight footage, is there anything you would have done differently, and what kind of stuff do you think that you did really well?
I think the one thing that I did well was listen to my corner. In terms of things I'd like to work on, I think being more explosive and just committing more, especially on my kicks, because I was landing body kicks, but they were doing a lot of damage. So I think I just need to step in more and work on being faster and more power behind it.
When it comes to the training here at Khongsittha, what was the training camp like leading up to both your fights, and how did it differ from training back at home?
The first week before my first fight, it was very difficult just to adjust to the heat and humidity. Not used to that back home. In terms of the intensity, I liked it. I like feeling like I'm dying in training because it makes me that much more focused when I fight. So I like that. The second fight, the week before that, it was kind of hell because one of the trainers, Egg, was really on top of me about kicking a lot, 100 kicks, you know, after 5 rounds of pads, 1,000 knees a day, and tons of teeps, and just having to push through all of that. It just makes you more mentally strong, so I liked it. I liked the training.
And then going back home, like, what do you think you'll be able to take from this camp moving forward to your training back home and when you start fighting again back in the States?
I think what I will take with me the most is just the intensity of training and pushing myself as hard as I can. In terms of fighting, it's different, you know, things are scored differently there. Judges appreciate different things. I won't have to be so concerned about kicking the body and kneeing the body and elbows, because it matters in the States to punch and leg kicks and stuff like that. So just being more well-rounded.
What was it like coming with 20 other Nak Muay and training in an atmosphere that was like a training camp atmosphere where everyone was here for pretty much the same purpose?
It's what sold me on the idea. This is actually the first time I've ever left the States. So I thought it might be good for me to kind of go through the same experience with others. I think it was a really good choice considering it's my first time leaving. Everyone's really great. It's nice to have other people who probably are in the same path or in the same spot in their journey in Muay Thai to be alongside you, to work together, to see each other grow. That's what it's all about. Promoting the sport and making yourself better and grow. And not only yourself, but others. So, rambling on.